Welcome back to Smartphone Wars. Hi there, this is Stephen Fox. Today I have here for you a bezel-less phone review. And it's not Doogee Mix. Which one is it? Watch my review and find out.
And this is the Bluebolt S1, a bezel-less phone for sub $200, and my first impressions are very good of the device. It looks very solid, feels very solid, looks gorgeous. The back panel is made of glass and the entire body is made of glass and plastic. Inside the package you do get a 10 watt fast charger, a USB type C cable, and you also get a silicone case protector for the back, as well as a tempered glass screen protector for the front, and you get a signed autograph from Bubu's president, kind of like in the OnePlus 5. It's a very nice touch. If you want to mimic a company, mimic a good company. The phone itself just absolutely looks stunning when you hold it. It's very good looking. The SIM tray is a dual nano SIM. And one of the SIM slots can be used for microSD card.
I know most of you out there really love a smaller footprint on a phone. It's a 5.5 inch, so you're not compromising screen size, but the body to screen ratio is very good and it feels like a 5 inch in your hand rather than a 5.5.
I'm very glad to see a very good one hand handling on 5.5 inch device, and this was not possible, but thanks to this new bezel-less design, it's very, very nice and comfortable to operate your big screen with one hand. And when comparing it to the Mi 5X, which is also a 5.5 inch device, you can definitely see it's much, much smaller in general.
The battery life is not up to par with the Snapdragon 625, but it's still okay. You'll get around 4 to 6 hours of screen on time using the Bluebolt S1. For battery life, this is quite okay. The GPS on this device works very well indeed because of the Helio P25. Again, it is running Android 7 or Nougat as well.
The S1 offers a very stock-like experience with Android, as most of the other devices I've reviewed. Using Android Nougat, it's 64 gigs of onboard storage, very nice for around $200, 4 gigs of RAM, and the Helio P25 does have two modes, a normal and a sports mode. I do suggest you run this phone in sports mode because it performs much better than in normal mode. 4 gigs of RAM, but definitely plenty of and enough for around $200 for this device and for any device in general. Although the RAM management I think can be a little bit better on this device and may improve with future updates. This is a very good multi-language ROM with dozens and dozens of languages supported. So for international users out there who want the UI in their own language, this is a very good option. And as you can see, it is running the latest July security patch and Android 7 Nougat.
The Helio P25 inside, definitely if you're running on sports mode rather than normal mode, you will get very good user experience, apps open quite quickly, multitasking is okay, the RAM management could be a little bit better, this tends to reload apps a bit more than I would like.
The Helio P25 has become a very, very used chip for smaller Chinese manufacturers who want a flagship performance but can't afford more expensive chips, and for those of you, the consumers, that would like a fast phone but don't want to pay as much. And it's good to see that this phone does have all the needed sensors and gyro and magnetoscope, The benchmarks are very okay around the Snapdragon 625 level. I see the very low RAM score even when using sports mode in this phone, so they've definitely opted for a cheaper RAM here, but the performance is quite okay. As you can see, split screen multitasking works very well on the Bluebell S1. I didn't see any screen recording options, so this feature is missing, but at least you get split screen multitasking. Since I know most of you are really concerned about gaming, here's some gaming tests. Modern Combat 5, a heavier first-person shooter on the Android market, and it's running quite well on the Bluebell S1. In general, I was pleased with the gaming performance of the phone. If you game for around 15-20 minutes, it just gets warmer on the back end, or if you're downloading plenty of apps using 4G, so the thermal experience is not the best, but it's definitely okay, nothing like too hot or anything. And as I said, these are all very, very good looking, very 3D demanding games that I've tried on the phone, and they all work quite well, even with the slower RAM speeds. So a very good gaming experience for around $200. And now let's check the audio experience from the main speaker.
The Bluebell S1 chose wisely with their camera sensors. The main camera is a Sony IMX214, which is far better than cheaper Samsung sensors that other companies like Doogee use or Blackview in their phones.
Yes, the Sony IMX214 is a sensor that I'm quite familiar with. I've tested in plenty of phones, and when I said it's better than the cheaper Samsung sensors, I mean it because of the very, very accurate colors and much less overexposure it gets in the images. If you're looking for a good phone to get photos in good light, this is a very good cheaper option for the bezel-less display. It does offer a better camera experience than most cheap Chinese phones when it comes to the main camera. And although the mono mode, which is a monochrome mode, is not really a mono mode, since it's a filter, doesn't have a monochrome sensor in there. As you can see, the photos are quite good from the Bluebell S1 when there's good lighting conditions, there's good dynamic range, accurate colors. And here's a mono sample. As I told you, the second sensor is just for depth of field, it's not a monochrome sensor, but the depth of field actually works quite well with this device. Although it's laggy when you use it, when you take the shot, it really looks okay. And of course, low light shots are not very good on the device, but that's expected for around $200. I do have to gripe with the video quality. Video quality looks okay, it does, again, thanks to the sensor, but there's too much focus hunting going on, and it's constant throughout the video, and I think this can definitely be fixed with the software update later on.
Front camera all the way here, down here, and you have to flip the phone every time you take a selfie. It's not very convenient, to say the least, and also the front camera is not very good.
The front camera is more of a quality of around $100 device. It's really entry level, some photos usable for social media, but some not quite good.
So you may be told that the Bluebell S1 is the perfect phone for you. Well, I have to insert a few big brackets here. One of them is definitely the software experience. This was definitely rushed to the market, and the software is definitely not quite there yet.
Now, because of the bezel-less display, there is no light sensor, so you have to adjust the brightness slider only manually. There is no automatic adaptive display for the sunlight, and the phone does have some really huge issues with AnTuTu. When you run AnTuTu in general, the screen just uses one touch point. You can't use multi-touch once you've opened AnTuTu. I don't know if it's something for the benchmark, but I've tested it later, this doesn't work in the browsing. But before you open AnTuTu or any benchmark, it does work, and I will demonstrate for you here. And I've had other issues as well with the software, like in 360 videos, the frame would freeze in general.
I also have some build quality issues with the Bluebell S1, but it's not regarding the display or regarding the shell in general, it's regarding the buttons.
My volume down button is barely working, I have to press it really hard to get it to work, and this is from day one. And the power button is very loose.
So in its current state, the BlueBlue S1 is definitely a phone I cannot recommend you rushing into, but if you're willing to take a chance on BlueBlue fixing those software issues, then you might have a very good phone in a few weeks. This has been Stephen Fox, thank you for watching my BlueBlue S1 video review. I hope I've helped you into picking or not picking a BlueBlue S1, since this is what I aim to do with all of my reviews. Give the video a thumbs up if you like it, subscribe to my channel if you like what I'm doing in general, and if you want more real and honest reviews of smartphones, stop watching paid reviews from other reviewers. They get paid to promote the product. I got this phone and I could have said it was great, but it's not. Subscribe to my channel if you really want an honest review on your products, the products that you're buying.
Stick around.